By 10 o'clock in the morning, a strange and almost incredible rumor was in full swing all over the town. It was received by society, of course, with full measure of spiteful joy, just as we all love to receive delightfully scandalous stories of anyone about us. "To lose one's sense of shame to such an extent," people said one to another. "To humiliate oneself so, and to neglect the first rules of propriety. To loose the bands of decency altogether, like this, really," etc., etc. But here is what had happened. Early in the morning, something after 6 o'clock, a poor, piteous-looking old woman came hurriedly to the door of Maria Alexandrovna's house, and begged the maid to wake Miss Zina up as quickly as possible, only Miss Zina, and very quietly, so that her mother should not hear of it, if possible. Zina, pale and miserable, ran out to the old woman immediately. The latter fell at Zina's feet, and kissed them, and begged her with tears to come with her at once to see poor Vasya, her son, who had been so bad all night, that she did not think he could live another day. The old woman told Zina that Vasya had sent to beg her to come, and bid him farewell in this, his death hour. He conjured her to come by all the blessed angels, and by all their past, otherwise he must die in despair. Zina at once decided to go, in spite of the fact that, by so doing, she would be justifying all the scandal and slanders disseminated about her in former days, as to the intercepted letter, her visits to him, and so on. Without a word to her mother, then, she donned her cloak and started off with the old woman, passing through the whole length of the town, into one of the poorest slums of Mordasov, and stopped at a little low, wretched house, with small, miserable windows, and snow piled round the basement for warmth.